I am Dr Neeta Shah Mehta, a practicing neurologist since last 40 years. I am professor neurology at Nanavati Super Speciality Hospital and was at Grant Medical College and Jaja Group of Hospital. We are going to talk about Parkinson's disease today, which is a very chronic disease, and as the age advances, the Parkinson's symptoms occur more. Parkinson's disease was diagnosed by Sir James Parkinson. However, it has been known in our ancient literature like Sushruta and Charak, and some allied treatment also has been started in those days. Basic symptoms of the Parkinson's are tremor, stiffness, that is rigidity, and slowing, that is what is called bradykinesia. The prevalence of Parkinson worldwide is almost 1% of the population. In India is 1% of the population above the age of 60. As the age advances, the Parkinson prevalence go on increasing, since it is a disease of the old age. But we also have another group where it is called young Parkinson, and the same symptom occur even below the age of 40. It has several symptoms like motor symptoms and non-motor symptoms. In the motor symptoms, basically it is tremors, slowing, and stiffness, that is what is called rigidity. The patient starts having onset either on one side or the other side, and then the whole body is involved. The disease progresses, and it is initial phase is ameliorated to the treatment part. The non-motor symptoms are basically many psychiatric symptoms, and as the disease advances, it can lead to dementia and depression also. In the initial phase, we have medical treatment for the Parkinson, and in the later phase, we also have a surgical treatment, which will be handled by my colleague. Thank you.
I am Dr. Anil Venkitachalam. I am a neurologist and movement disorder specialist at Nanavati Super Speciality Hospital in Mumbai. I am going to speak today on Parkinson's disease. The exact cause of Parkinson's disease is not known. Genetic factors are known to play a role to cause Parkinson's disease. Apart from this, environmental factors and various toxins have also known to be implicated in Parkinson's disease. The major problem in Parkinson's disease is a degeneration of the dopaminergic cells in the brain. As a result of this, the amount of dopamine in the brain reduces, and this further leads to the symptoms of Parkinson's disease. The patient presents with symptoms of slowness, rigidity, tremor, and loss of balance. Apart from this, the patient also presents with certain non-motor symptoms like constipation, loss of memory, depression, and severe pain. The risk factors for Parkinson's disease include male sex, a positive family history, a history of head injury. Parkinson's disease is traditionally known to occur in the elderly population. The incidence of Parkinson's disease increases by 1% every year over the age of 65. However, younger people are also known to be affected with Parkinson's disease. Parkinson's disease is the only neurodegenerative disorder which has a treatment. There are very good treatment options for Parkinson's disease if the disease is diagnosed early. The treatment option mainly includes the replacement of dopamine in the brain. This mainly consists of medications such as the dopamine agonist or levodopa, which you have to take on a regular basis. The patient has to be seen by a neurologist or a movement disorder specialist in order for the medication to be started. As the disease advances and progresses, the symptoms get worse and the patient may not be responsive to oral therapy. As a result, the patient may need to be offered other options of treatment, which also includes a surgical management for Parkinson's disease. In advanced Parkinson's disease, when the patient does not respond to conventional oral therapy, surgery can be offered as an option. Here mainly The surgery is the deep brain stimulation surgery, which is the cornerstone of therapy for advanced Parkinson's disease. Here mainly, pacemakers are inserted into the brain and the brain is like stimulated to lead to a continuous dopaminergic stimulation, thereby relieving the symptoms of Parkinson's disease. However, a lot of patients are not candidates for deep brain stimulation surgery, and many patients develop side effects and refractoriness to oral medication. For such patients, newer therapies are available. One of the newer treatments that is available is an apomorphine pump and pen therapy. The apomorphine pen or a pump infusion can be used for patients with advanced Parkinson's disease when they develop symptoms of advanced Parkinson's disease, such as freezing, falling, or dyskinesias. It is very useful in the management of advanced Parkinson's disease. It has been available in Europe for a long time and has been very successful in treating patients, especially the elderly population. It is being launched and available in India for the first time for the treatment of advanced Parkinson's disease. Thank you.